Good morning, children. Welcome. Now we are there in the lesson 3, that is tanks and groundwater. Okay, already we have discussed in the last class how tanks are protecting us. Who has constructed tanks, children? Yes, during the period of Kakatiya and Vijayanagara. During the period of Kakatiya and Vijayanagara. Nagara, these kings has constructed many tanks so that the tanks are giving water facilities for the village people and also it is giving water facilities for the nearby fields. We already discussed in the previous class. Yes. Yeah. So tanks are protecting us in many ways. It is not only for us, it is helping for animals also. Animals also are drinking water. And also it is improving the water level in the wells. In Telugu we will call as bavi. Okay. So it is improving the water level in the wells. And also giving more facilities to the people who are living in villages. And also during drought period, when there are not good rains, so this water is utilized during the drought period to grow some crops in the villages. These all things we have discussed in the previous class. And also I told you about Vision Kakatiya. So present, what we are doing? We people, are we protecting these tanks? No, we are not protecting these tanks. What we are doing? When they play the land of tank, is the tank is completely dried up, what we are using? We are using that land for constructing of roads, houses. Day by day these tanks are getting declined. So full, when it rains, what happens? The full water, it is coming to our houses as well as on the roads. We are feeling uncomfortable just because of declining of roads. So our Telangana government, to rectify these all problems, it has implemented one great scheme, that is Mission Kakatiya. What is Mission Kakatiya? Yes. Their target is to plant 4,07,000. Their target is to purify 4,07,000 tanks. 4,07,000 tanks should be purified. So already the tanks are constructed in different areas in Telangana by different kings, military people we discussed. So their target is to clear all the silt and sediments, dust and any damage for that lake, the construction work, this all should be cleaned. This all should be completed and the silt should be removed from the tank bunds. See here, total 4,07,000 tanks should be purified. This is the target of Mission Kakatiya. Right now, many tanks, nearly about 2,000 tanks were purified. So, next. The next thing is fishing in tanks. So, not only for irrigation facilities beta, it is also the fishing. Tanks are giving livelihood for the fishermen. See, fishing in tanks, the people who will do the fishing facility, fishing in tanks, them we will call as Ganga Putra. In Telugu, we will call as Besta. So these people will do the fishing in tanks. And also Gondla and Mudiraj. In Telugu we call it Telugu under. Gondla and Mudiraj, community people. These people will work. Their livelihood is a, what is their livelihood? Fishing. Catching the fishes, selling in the markets. So that is the tanks are giving the livelihood for the fishermen also. Next. One, we will talk about one village called Bedavolu village. What is this Bedavolu village? It is located near the Suryapet, Kodada. It is there near Suryapet, Kodada. There one person called Bedala Reddy. That a person, who is that person you know? Who is that person you know? This person is the subordinate of Kakatiya Kingdom. And it is the kingdom person anamata, nayakudu, one of the subordinate of Kakatiya Kingdom. Aina peru Bedala Reddy. class. On his name, they kept that village name as Betavolu village. Are you clear and understood better? So he is the person who worked in during the period of Kakatiya subordinates. Villagers, see, listen carefully. According to the village elders, Betavolu get its name from Betala Reddy, the subordinate of Kakatiya. He got that tank built on his name of his wife. Tan em chesadu, what he has done, Betavolu Betala Reddy, he is the subordinate of Kakatiya, no? So in his Betavolu village, he constructed one tank, and that tank name, what he has kept, he kept his, the name of this tank is Veerala Devi Cheruvu, Veerala Devi tank. He kept on his wife name. See, if wherever you go for a village, there will be one name for that tanks or cheruvu. We will call them as cheruvu in Telugu. So there will be some story about that. So Veerala Devi Cheruvu, which is located in Betavolu village, and this name has given by the Betala Reddy and by on his wife name Veerala Devi, and he is the subordinate to the Kakatiya kings. Are you able to understand, children, how they got the village name and how they kept the name of the tank? Next, what you know, this tank is giving 1900 acres of land. It is irrigating the 1900 acres of land. So by this lake, they are producing different types of crops in 1900 acres of land. It's a great thing, right? One tank is giving this much water facilities for these many acres of land. Think about different tanks in different places. How much production will we getting? So in our times, we are declining all the tanks and we are using for our personal use, for personal purpose. Day by day, there is a decline of tanks and we are getting lot of problems by the stream flood during the time of floods. Next, in the village today, even though originally it was meant to irrigate about 3000 acres, the Ayakatta has been reduced to the illegal encroachments on the tank bed and due to silting. Yes, today also better. Today what happens, it has improved a lot. It has improved a lot and it is giving the 3000 acres of land irrigation facilities. So 3000 acres of land it is giving irrigation facilities. It's a very, very great thing. Yes or no? That's why we are discussing this Betavolu village, which is there in Suryapet, Kodada district. Next. On the tank bed is situated the shrines of Kattavaisamma and Gangamma. See, every village is having one tank. So, at that border of that tank, one temple is constructed. We will say that Kattavaisamma. So, we will give some offerings to her to protect our village. In that way, they have constructed for this lake also one temple. And that temple is called as Kattavaisamma or Gangamma. Okay, next, and they used to celebrate our festivals. We'll celebrate Bonalu festival in our villages, no? We'll be giving some offerings to the goddesses Maisamma. Same like that only, they used to also have different festivals on her name. Next, there are about 600 families of Besta and Mudraj community in Betavolu village, out of which 60 to 70 households are leading their lives. See here, completely Besta and Gondla and Mudraj community people, nearly 60 to 70 families are there itself. Completely their livelihood is dependent on the tank. Their livelihood completely depended on the tanks. So, however, they fish in the tank only during the months of March and April. During the rest of the year, they work as small farmers or laborers. So, when they are doing the fishing, when they are doing it, it is in the month of March and April. Very one mark question or bit question. March and April. They will do the fishing in the month of March and April because of heavy evaporation during these days. March and April is the summer months. Summer days. period, they will work as a small workers or small farmers or some laborers. They will search for other work. Okay, this is the about Betavolu village. Clear everybody? Next. Yeah, next topic is about fishes in tanks. In tanks, different types of fishes we have. So not only one type of fish we are eating, we will eat different fishes like koramattalu, bocce. We will be calling in different names. So in tanks we have different types of fishes, and each fish will be having its own taste. So see here, fishes in tanks. See different fishes better names. You see jellalu, kunta mukkulu, koraminulu, pulushalu, etc. These type of fishes, so many fishes which are present in tanks. But some fishes are disappearing. Now that some type of fishes were not existing because some pesticides and chemicals which are used in the water bodies and also in agriculture fields. So some type of fishes are disappeared. Right now we are using which type of fishes, you know? We are using merigay, ravva, bocce and bangaru tiga. Only these fishes we are using. Next, each fish has its own special taste. Did you taste anybody? Different types of fishes, did you taste? Yes, I hope everybody tasted. Next, for catching this fish, they use different types of nets. Okay, see here. For that, sannapu vala, listen here. The fishermen use nets of different kinds to catch the fish. There would be 30 kannulu. Kannulu means nothing but holes. In small purusha, thinner net, where has 60 kannulu, in big purusha, thicker net. See here, there are different types of nets, children. In one type of net, they are having 30 holes. And another type of net, they are having 60 holes. It depends upon the fish, which type of fish they are going to catch. It depends upon that fish, they use the different types of nets. Next, sannapu vala weighs less. Yes, see sannapu vala, one type of net it is, its weight is very less. They catch fish and prawns by sannapu vala. What type of fishes they are catching here? Prawns and small fishes they used to catch. Doddu vala is used to catch the fish of weight about 100 grams to 5 kilos. So, doddu vala, they are using bigger 60 holes net to catch which type of fishes? 100 kgs fishes as well as 5, it should be more 5 kilos of weight. Next, visire vala is used when there is less water in the tank. Kachu vala weighs less. Fisherman go further in the stable water and spread the kachu vala. Yes, two types of nets are there, beta. What are those? Visire vala. It is used for less water. Where there is less water, they'll use visire vala. Kachu vala. Another net it is kachu vala. Where they use this type of net? They use in the deep waters to catch the big fishes. They use the deep waters. Why I am saying these all names? They will ask 4 marks or 2 marks. Name the different types of nets. Name the different types of tanks. You have to remember these all names and write in your running notes also. It is very, very important to read the textbook. And whatever the points I am writing on the board, you have to note it down in the notebook. Clear everybody? In the next class, I am going to tell about the part 2 and also about the Cooperative Society of Fishermen. Thank you very much.